Color management in Maya is based on OCIO, which is short for Open Color I/O. OCIO is an open standard library that has been adopted by the Academy Software Foundation. It is integrated into many software applications that deal with color. You set up color management in the Maya preferences. However, many of these settings are actually stored in the scene. OCIO uses a configuration file, which is usually just called a config. The config is a text file in YAML format that defines the color spaces and transforms that are available. The same config can be used by many creation, compositing, and editing software packages. This allows for consistent treatment of colors in a single project or across a facility. The Maya installation contains two configs. The default config for new scenes is based on ACES, the Academy Color Encoding System. The legacy config is used for compatibility in scenes from Maya 2020 and earlier. You can also select the legacy config if you prefer not to use the ACES defaults for a new scene. If your scene uses a specific config, you can browse and select that instead. It's best to set up color management right at the start of a new scene or project. If you change settings later, you might need to set up the lighting again and adjust any colors that are saved in the scene. Even if another config contains the same color spaces, just with different names, you'll get errors when loading a scene. The rendering space is the color space in which the lighting and rendering calculations are performed. All the choices in Maya's default config are scene linear, which is necessary to be physically accurate, as well as compatible with the math used by modern renderers. A config can contain several transforms organized into displays and views. Each display can have a different set of views, so you should select the display first. It corresponds to the device that you are viewing on. The view transform is meant to convert the high dynamic range of the scene to the standard dynamic range of the display. The default is the ACES tone map. It has a photographic response to give a pleasant image that emulates the overall digital cinema process. The results are a bit darker than some people are used to, but they are a better match for real footage. If you prefer the older workflow that simply applies or removes gamma as appropriate, you can use untone mapped. But note that color values in the scene that are above 1 simply get clipped by the display. Thanks for watching.